Jones looking to become the second 45-year-old fighter to capture a portion of the heavyweight title after George Foreman's stunning upset of Michael Moorer. Ironically, Holmes returns to the scene of his first heavyweight championship back in 78 against Ken Norton. Can he do it again 17 years later? We'll find out shortly.
Holmes and Holmes.
Let's go. Throw it. Stay out.
Get out from the front of the field.
Damn, my buddy. Guys, you got to walk. You want to go. Come on.
Yes, it feels like we've turned back the clocks. An old refrain. Larry Holmes, the pride of Easton, PA, 61-4, 40 knockouts, 20-4 in world title fights. He's beaten 9 world champs, including Ken Norton, Leon Spinks, Trevor Burbick, and Muhammad Ali. He defended his title 19 times over the course of 7 years, an incredible accomplishment eclipsed only by the 25 defenses of Joe Louis. Since launching his comeback in January of 88, following a 2-year leave of absence, Holmes is 13 up and 2 down with his 2 losses to then undisputed heavyweight champions Mike Tyson and Evander Holyfield. He is rated number 8 by the WBC. So he is now waiting for the ring walk of the champion Oliver McCall, and there is the championship belt, and here is the champion Oliver the Atomic Bull McCall out of Chicago, Illinois, a 2-1 favorite. McCall turns 30 later this month. Tonight he enters the ring with the burden to prove that his victory over Lennox Lewis was not an accident.
Oh, yeah.
winning demeanor on the face of Oliver McCall, making the long and slow walk in. Took 9 years for the personable and outgoing McCall outside of the ring to become an overnight success thanks to his heroics in London. He has handled the pressures of being heavyweight champion very well, thriving on the attention. On the longest knockout streak of his career, having sent the last six of his victims to the canvas, 13 of his 18 knockout victims have fallen in the first two rounds. Let's check the numbers as we go to the tail of the tape. And the first thing that jumps out, of course, the age. Holmes at 45, 16 years older than McCall. Slight height advantage for Holmes. Holmes weighed in at 236, McCall 231. The reach close, 1-inch advantage Holmes. And to the WBC rules for this championship fight. 10-point must scoring system, 3 scoring judges, no standing 8 count, no 3 knockdown rule, only the referee can stop the fight, and a fighter cannot be saved by the bell except in the final round. So here at Caesars Palace in Las Vegas, Nevada, we're closing in on the finale of 5 world championship fights, the one we've been waiting for, our main event, the WBC heavyweight championship, Oliver McCall versus Larry Holmes. Let's go up to our ring announcer, the classy Jimmy Lennon Jr.
Ladies and gentlemen, we welcome you to the home of champions, Caesars Palace, here in Las Vegas, Nevada, for the main event of the evening, brought to you by Don King Productions and King Vision, in association with Showtime Event Television, La Cerveza Más Fina, Corona Beer, and Caesars Palace. This bout is scheduled for 12 rounds of boxing and is sanctioned by the World Boxing Council, President Jose Suleiman, Supervisor Edward Tungaraja, along with the Nevada State Athletic Commission, the Chairman, Dr. James Nave, Commissioners Nat Carasali, Dr. Elias Ghanem, Luther Mack, and Crispin Rivera, with the Executive Director, Mark Ratner. Physicians at ringside, Dr. Flip Pomansky, Dr. James Game, Dr. William Berliner, and Dr. Charles Signorino. Timekeepers at the bell also keeping count of the knockdowns, Jane Broadfoot, Al Bisek, and Mike LaSella. Introducing to you the judges scoring this bout from ringside, Chuck Jampa, Barbara Perez, and Tomotsu Tomihara. All right, fans, here we go with the main event of the evening, the burden of proof. And now, ladies and gentlemen in attendance and boxing fans joining us around the world, it's showtime! With the WBC Heavyweight Championship of the World, 12 rounds of boxing. Introducing to you the referee in charge of the bout, working in this his 110th world title bout, Richard Steele. Introducing to you first, ladies and gentlemen, the challenger on my right. He is fighting out of the blue corner. He enters the ring wearing white trunks with red trim and fighting out of Easton, Pennsylvania. He weighed in at a ready 236 pounds and his record includes 61 wins, only 4 losses with 40 wins coming by way of knockout. Here is the legendary former heavyweight champion who defended his crown 19 times, currently ranked the WBC number 8 contender, introducing the one and only Easton assassin, Larry Holmes. And his opponent across the ring, the defending world champion on my left, fighting out of the red corner. He enters the ring ready to fight, wearing black trunks with red trim, hailing from Chicago, Illinois. His weight, 231 pounds, with a record of 25 wins and 5 losses. He has 18 wins coming by way of knockout. And tonight, he is making the first defense of his title. Please welcome the newly crowned WBC heavyweight champion of the world, known as the Atomic Bull, introducing Oliver McCall. Once again, here's your referee in charge. Now to give instructions, Richard Steele.
All right, I spoke to both fighters in the dressing room. I'm cautioning again. Obey my commands at all times. I want a good, clean fight. In case of a knockdown and you're standing, you go to the neutral corner. Remain in the corner until I tell you to come out. Shake hands and good luck.
Moment of truth, fellas.
McCall looking angry. Holmes very loose. Let's check the weather conditions for our main event. It is very clear and present and comfortable. 69 degrees, a slight breeze, humidity 20% here at Caesars Palace in Las Vegas, Nevada. We get set for the WBC Heavyweight Championship. Oliver McCall, he has paid his dues. Larry Holmes, in his heyday, a brilliant boxer, a master of the jab. The question now, does he still have the speed and force behind the jab? Here we go, round one scheduled for 12 for the title. Can Larry Holmes take Oliver McCall to school? Cannot get into a punching contest as he goes right at McCall with the right hand.
And his jab, which has always been his best feature. He's come up popping that jab hard. We expected that.
Don't hold him. Break.
Oliver's going to look to crowd and rough him up and do some things that any young, strong man would do to an old man. But Larry's going to look to take him to school and use that jab. He was talking to him as they stared down at the referee's instructions.
McCall paying no attention to Holmes. Question is, which McCall will show up tonight? The fighter who goes on a seek and destroy mission or the sparring partner, the fighter who lets his opponent dictate the fight?
Well, he is
to get out.
Wanting to get out of here early. He is not looking for any mercy here. He's trying to make this fight end quickly, and we just started out. So you can see it's a McCall that likes the battle that we've got tonight.
Larry's going to have to take a little bit of a page out of Ali in his later years. Hit him with the jab on the wing. When you get in, grab you, not let you go until he's ready, and then take that jab with you on the way out.
Larry likes to lay on the ropes.
He's holding his hands way low as Larry.
Looking to take McCall out of his game plan. One thing you cannot question, and I think you pointed it out, Ferdy, is Holmes' heart. Midway through the round, opening round, McCall's best weapon, the overhand right. There it is.
Tell you what, there was an even cuter right hand by Larry.
Oh, Larry suckered him in to right the right range and drop the right hand perfectly, as a good veteran will do.
It didn't seem to affect
Oliver, but he sure was a good one. Nice little crisp right hand by Oliver, by Holmes.
Got none for you, baby.
McCall, big, strong upper body.
That's right.
Helpful for infighting, especially if Holmes does lay on the ropes. Got a solid chin, McCall. Never KO'd as a pro.
Right now, McCall's not giving any kind of movement. He's just standing right in front of Larry, which is kind of not the way to fight him.
A little bit of a waiting game going on here by both fighters. Right now, Larry getting the better of it.
Well, you expect Oliver to do a little bit more motion than this. He is almost like perplexed by this jab that's coming out, which is pretty strong right now. Not the great one of the old days, but pretty respectable. Larry's got that jab.
You know, sometimes what happens with the fighters when they score a one-punch knockout, they start looking for that, and Oliver may very well be looking too much for one shot.
Holmes looking to end it with one punch, missing with the overhand right. Final seconds of the opening round. Both McCall and Holmes appear to be in superb condition as the bell sounds. Well, here at the Home of Champions, earlier tonight in the ring at Caesars Palace, this is one for the books. A shot for all ages. Sugar Ray Leonard on the right of your screen. Tommy Hearns in the middle. Marvelous. Marvin Hagler on the left. What a scene.
And that is a sufficiency of riches. Those were the guys that made it all during the 70s and 80s.
No, I had to get the first one out.
Okay, now you got to go over the jab. Now, do me a favor. Go out there and jab this guy to death. See, when you're jabbing, he can't get his right hand on.
I know.
Now, but you got to double up on your jab. Jab two, jab two. Set for two. One, two.
You the man.
Here we go. Go get him.
You the man, big guy. Be the boss.
Stay
Both fighters in the first round looking to end it on one punch. Not much style in evidence. And George Benton says, go to the jab to Oliver McCall. Let's see some boxing.
That's odd. Benton's working in two quarters and two championship fights, and he's saying the same thing. Use that jab. If you don't hit the head, hit the shoulder, hit something.
Well, I'll tell you what, I don't think Larry really was trying for a one-punch knockout, but what I think he was trying to do was gain that respect he's going to need if he wants to keep Oliver off and keep Oliver respectful.
Well, I think he got his respect because Oliver quit fighting toward the end of that round, just stood in front of him like he had no more ideas. Like, uh-oh, I tried what I came here for, nothing worked. I mean, you know, he's got to get back to his game plan of motion and fast punching and so forth. He hasn't done that. I mean, so in that case, Larry did win that war.
And you wonder if Holmes is a threat to knock out a strong young fighter, but he does still possess a crisp left-right combination. He has the big reach. He is in good shape, as mentioned. He tries to set a comfortable pace for himself, knows how to conserve energy. His chin has become vulnerable.
Right now, Larry's boxing nice, and he's getting the better of it, but, you know, Oliver's got a long fight ahead of him. You got 12 rounds. We're only in the second round, so we'll see where the youth and strength start to take over.
I think somewhere along the line, he's got to get over the idea that he's in there with the great Larry Holmes. I mean, some of that rubs off on you. You see a guy that you saw since you were a kid, you can't believe you're in there with this big guy, and he's big, and Larry's big, and he's smart, and he knows how to box. So it's going to take some time, but Oliver's got to wake up here on the second or third round and start fighting his fight.
McCall, a 2.5-1 favorite at fight time. Rugged brawler. Solid chin. Not a defensive whiz, but should be able to slip Holmes' punches. So far, doing it. There's that jab of Holmes.
Oliver's got a crowd, Larry, a little more if he's going to give himself a chance to start to wear him down. If he lets Larry do this, I'm telling you, 45 or 55, Larry can do that box with that jab all day long.
Yeah, then it becomes whether he can take it at 45 all the way to 12 rounds. Right now, he's fighting the kind of fight that Larry wanted to fight.
This, of course, was the round in which McCall ended Lennox Lewis's reign as champion. The second round with a big overhand. Right there's a right hand, but Holmes showing some defense, able to stave him off.
Larry's got those big, huge arms, and boy, more than one fighter has gone down trying to figure out how to get through that flailing big arms, bunch of muscles that Larry's got. He's so smart in how to use those arms.
20 seconds. Well, early in his career, he beat Norton, Shavers, Cooney, Weaver. Stopped 38-year-old Muhammad Ali in 1980. McCall has never really challenged the best of the division. Took on three world champions before or after they were champions. As we head for the bell.
He's trying to go over top of the jab, right?
I know.
Deep inhale. So now listen. Jab at his belly, but lean down with the jab at his belly. Listen, look at me. When you jab at his belly, lean over to your, lean way down to your right. So you'll be damn near, your head will be damn near to his waist, but over on the side. You understand what I'm saying? So don't be jabbing at the head too much.
Yeah.
Because it,
you see it, you done opened him up twice.
Larry looks like the chairman of the board. He looks like he's at a board meeting. The other guy looks like he's a nervous wreck. He's huffing, he's puffing. I think the nerves are on the part of Oliver McCall. After all, Larry has been here so long, and he's such a veteran. I mean, he's like he's holding a board meeting. But, you know, Oliver's always been a flighty kind of edgy guy. Nice right hand.
Oliver smiled, but he's not doing the right thing right now. He's taking his time too much, and he's not working. Got to work harder. Got to forget about Larry's right hand. He got to start working the body and come inside.
And get away from that right hand and circling right into it. But the other thing is that right hand, although it's missing, is changing Oliver's game plan. He's respecting it too much. I mean, Larry's throwing it with all his power. He's missing, but it's really kind of frightening Oliver McCall. It's changing his game plan. And so far, he has not jabbed to the body like he said he was, like his instructions from Georgie Benton. I think that's a very dangerous thing to do when a guy's got a right hand like Oliver, like Holmes.
This fight has already gone longer than McCall's title victory over a much younger Lennox Lewis.
Don't hold him. Great. Step back. Step back.
Larry Holmes won't make any of the big mistakes that Lennox Lewis would make at this stage of his career. He's been here before. It's just a matter of now, can he get that body to do what he wants his mind to do?
McCall with a right hand. He predicted a third round knockout. Now going to the ribs.
It was a nice right hand, but it didn't do any real damage. And on the inside, he's holding Oliver pretty good, and Oliver's using a lot of energy. So we'll see what happens.
Holmes finding his way, but staying against the rope.
I don't remember when I've seen Holmes as crisp and as hard in years. I don't remember in years that he's thrown punches as hard.
I talked to Larry yesterday, and as I said, we've been good friends for about 10 years now. He has looked and sounded as well as he ever has with me for the past 5 years.
Holmes doing a little toying, a little playing around. McCall takes exception. Holmes says he does feel great. He didn't feel right when he fought Holyfield in 92. Losing decision. Undisputed heavyweight title at the time. You'll recall he threw up in the ring, had problems with his contact. Feels great tonight.
Don't hold it.
You ever wonder why a fighter wears contact lenses in a fight?
Larry uses contact lenses. It still boggles my mind that he could even try that. I know he had problems with it in the Holyfield fight, caused him some problems. I guess his vision is just much more clear, and he likes it that way, because I've never asked him specifically, but that's strange.
Well, Larry's found a home in that corner because he's not getting out. He must think he can outthink him and outfight him in that corner. No motion, standing there taking these punches.
How smart is this? How intelligent is this against a guy like McCall to lay on the ropes?
Well, if you know what you're doing, like Larry is, you know, uses his elbows so much as he did in the Holyfield fight, you know, hey, this guy is really cagey man. I mean, he knows boxing. He is a professor.
Let's not forget he's 45 years old, and this is where he can save energy.
Yep.
Hit me low.
I know.
He hit me low, Donald. Tell the ref.
All right.
Richie. Give me the mouthpiece. Give me the mouthpiece. Put the
bucket
on the way.
Come on, baby. Come on. Larry, you got him in the corner.
Two looks at this right hand by McCall. Bang. Now, that hit pretty good. I mean, that drove Larry into the ropes, and then he stayed in that corner. Let's take another look at it. Bobby,
Back and you watch this, this is kind of similar to what happened when he fought the Englishman, Lennox Lewis. He took off a right, swung with it, turned in, and fired his own. He didn't land this one as cleanly.
You know one thing I'm seeing in McCall that surprises me? He closes his eyes when a punch is coming toward him. I mean, really closes his eyes.
I didn't notice that on the replay.
Now, watch him on the next replays. He's been closing his eyes as a big punch has come. That's not good news.
Round four scheduled for 12. Let's see if Holmes takes McCall right back to the ropes. Holmes able to elbow Holyfield, you recall, on the ropes in similar fashion. He cut Holyfield. Holmes, when he went back to his corner, he told his trainer, Don Turner, he's hitting me low. There's a right hand that pushes McCall back.
You know, McCall keeps smiling and he just does a nice walk around. The punches aren't hurting him, but they're getting through and he shouldn't be letting them.
That's right. Nice prison, baby. Nice prison.
A smacking right by McCall. McCall smothering Holmes again against the ropes, trying to go to the body.
He's turning in some decent body shots, but they're not real clean, not real solid, and he's going to use a lot of energy digging that hard.
And Larry complaining again to the referees, getting hit low. I didn't see that many low blows. I'll tell you the truth, I didn't see any. So, I mean, it's Larry's getting hit, so it must be, but I don't see him.
He mentioned it to his trainer, Don Turner, between rounds.
Larry Holmes knows how to work the referee a little bit.
Yeah, that's part of being a great pro also. I mean, you work the referee, you work everything you can.
Here's a jab followed up by right there, just missed by Holmes. McCall able to sidestep that potential damage.
Now McCall beginning to to feel the rhythm of the fight.
Right hand by McCall.
He's been stiff and kind of scary like, and he is now starting to get in the rhythm. Two, three jabs, then followed by a right, then push him into the ropes. He's getting in there. He's getting the idea that he can take this guy. And
let's go, Larry, get off the rope.
And his attack has been proven better this round.
Richard Steele says, keep it clean. Here's McCall opening up on Holmes.
Once again, Larry's drawing him into the corner. I don't know if he wants that fight there for any particular reason other than he can rest, lean on the ropes, and use them to save energy.
He can sure use his elbows well, too, Bobby. This guy really knows when he's in close. He knows how to use that elbow.
As mentioned, that's what he did against Holyfield, using the elbow, but here comes McCall.
Fight gets very difficult here for Larry, being 45, having to deal with the extra strength.
Now McCall takes a step back, takes a big deep breath, and comes right back forward on Larry Holmes.
And he knows Larry's right hand is coming.
10 seconds left of the fourth round.
Right, step back.
And there's the bell. Let's go up to Jim Hill and Marvelous Marvin Hagler. Jim?
All right, Steve, thank you very much. And Marvin, you mentioned a little while ago that at the beginning of the fight, this was a completely different Oliver McCall.
Yeah, I went to the gym there and watched him work out, and he looked terrific. He came in, you see, the first, second round, just looking for the knockout. There was no art there at all, and maybe if he's calmed down this next round, he put his punches together.
Are you surprised that Larry is on the ropes as much as he is?
Well, I figured that anyway, that Larry's going to lay on the ropes and hopefully catch him coming in with his right hand. And hoping that I see Oliver look a little amorous.
A little amateurish?
Yeah, a little amorous.
What's the reason for that? Could it be the surrounding? Is his first title defense?
Well, this is exactly what I was waiting to see, how he was going to react to his first championship defense. Yeah.
Okay, let's go back down the ringside and Steve Albers. Steve?
All right, Jim and Marvin, thank you very much. Final instructions from Georgie Benton. And here we go, round number five. For the WBC Heavyweight Championship, Oliver McCall in his first defense. We're waiting for Larry Holmes. Here he comes. Holmes doing a lot of blinking. Here's the right hand, overhand right now. He goes to the body, does Holmes. McCall glancing over to Richard Steele.
That's what took him so long. That tape is coming off the glove.
That's why. So now they got to put another piece of tape over that or cut it off. Let's see what they do. Going to the tape. And the old tape flies right down to the Ferdy's hands. Nice
catch. Double left jab, just like the door. Double left jab.
All right, we're ready to resume here in round number five.
Larry's come out here for this round as the aggressor, taking an offensive posture, and Oliver seems to be fine letting him do that. He doesn't really want to force the fight, force the action, and meet him midway, making the older man maybe use a little more energy.
Yeah, he doesn't want to mix it up. He doesn't want to exchange with him. He just lets him punch up. He's punching in the air most of the time, but that jab is coming out there pretty good. I didn't think he'd have that much of a jab.
Big right hand, but back comes McCall, powering after the Holmes right.
Keep him up.
Nice body work.
Body is Oliver McCall.
No holding.
That's where it hurts when you're 45 years old.
Pounding to the midsection. With his hands down by his side, dangerous.
But McCall shouldn't play that. Come right on in and fight.
I agree.
Yeah, forget that. Only one guy needs that. He doesn't need that.
This is similar to what Holmes tried to do to Evander Holyfield. And he's trying to make McCall fall into his trap.
And look at
again, he looks over.
Oh, that's awful. That's just awful. You can't do that.
I'm not totally sure what's going through all of his mind right now. Like I said, I know both these guys pretty well.
Right hand by Larry Holmes.
He keeps turning and walking away. I can't help but think he's going to leap in with something as a surprise, but I'm going to be the one surprised.
Look, he's looking at us.
Now he's looking at us, and he's dancing around.
Look at this. I mean, what is he, flying? I mean, what is all this motion? Not since Chris Eubank did all those strange motions in England have I seen a guy do all this crazy stuff.
You know, Tommy Marshall did a lot of walking around a similar fashion with George Foreman, jumping in with some jabs, but George was a big puncher.
and Tommy forced to be the boxer. Here, Larry's the
nice
boxer.
Nice right hand. Nice right hand. Has Holmes holding on.
Less than 30 seconds to go in round five. There's a miss, but McCall comes back with a limp, charging into Holmes against the ropes.
Holding that Holmes now resigned to taking body shots. I don't know what he's doing. There's a lot of talking going on here. This looks like the Royal Shakespearean Theater rather than a boxing match. What are you, acting here?
Have to get out. Break. Stop.
Final seconds of the round.
Look at Larry.
And Holmes just in statuesque fashion just standing there. And now has a word for Richard Steele.
Get these arms down.
How you feel? You got throughout these? Listen. Now you're boxing.
Now get these arms down.
That's it. Now listen. Oliver. Right, now you're not throwing yourself away. That's the way to use the jab. I see double up on the jab.
Watch the backhand, okay?
Okay, baby.
Okay, I will.
Keep it clean.
Okay. I wasn't trying, okay.
All right, deep your nails, way up.
Now, when you get close, now, remember, hit it on the front of the arm. Now, see, that's not the way. Take that right hand and wear that damn jab arm out. Right? But come back with your left hook. Come back with your left hook so you camouflage it. You see what I mean?
Let's take a look at Holmes, one of these wide misses. He misses. And also McCall misses, but he comes back with a second shot and a third. And, of course, that is points for McCall. Take a look at it overhead, Bobby.
Yeah, you see as he misses. And then, again, is that the same right hand he hit Lennox Lewis, but only was a little straighter and a little cleaner. But that's the counter right hand that McCall likes to land.
Yeah, I just wish they'd quit play acting because it's not necessary. Let him fight. The only guy that wins there is Holmes. He's got the times.
Round six. Holmes asking for McCall to mix it up in round five. Does he really want that?
Once again, Larry comes out as the aggressor. Oliver walks away kind of nonchalantly.
Larry just standing there the last 10 seconds of the fifth round and then having a little conversation with Richard Steele as the bell sounded. McCall dancing around up on the balls of his feet against a stationary target, Larry Holmes. There's that jab that connects by McCall, the left jab.
Well, McCall is not impressing. He may be winning these rounds, but he's not impressing. Those are two good jabs by Holmes. Good
now he looks jab. Away again, does McCall, this time to the other side.
Well, I'm not sure I understand that at all, Steve McCarty.
No, maybe Riddick Bowe has finally found a companion. Mysterious things that these guys do in the ring.
Loading up with the right, McCall. Well, he's got some unusual moves in the ring.
Yeah, this is a sort of disco dancer fighting.
Right hand by Holmes. It tagged McCall, then he goes to the ribs.
Larry's throwing some punches now that he means business.
Yeah, he's like opening up and saying, okay, let's get to a fight here.
Holmes very, very serious right now. He was toying, playing around before. Now he's stalking McCall, waiting for his opening. Oh, an overhand right to the back of Oliver McCall. Then a missed uppercut by Oliver McCall.
So Oliver's not even really working enough to win the round, even if he were being effective, and he's not being effective. I'm not sure what he's doing. Maybe we'll have to take Larry into the later rounds and work using that age factor, but I don't know.
Again, McCall looking away. He's democratic. He's looking everywhere.
Break. Come on. Let him go.
But Larry is the one that's carrying the action in this round. Larry is the one that's trying to fight and doing everything. The other guy is just sort of reacting in that theatrical fashion.
Larry Holmes using all of his experience, summoning all up that experience against the younger Oliver McCall. 20 seconds to go in the sixth round. Holmes blinking away. McCall looking away. Now McCall dancing around, looks over to ringside. 5 seconds in the round. There's the jab by McCall as he finishes the round in dancing fashion. Let's go over to Jim Gray right now. Jim.
Thank you. Thank you, Steve. I'm here with Larry Holmes Jr. And Larry, how do you think your dad's doing so far?
Pretty good. We're good.
You're nervous. You're losing your voice, aren't you?
Yeah.
How tough is it to watch your dad fight?
hard. I don't like coming anymore. It's nerve-wracking.
Anymore? How many times did you see him fight when he was champion, and do you remember it?
Like once or twice, and I don't remember at all.
What's he like to be around at home after he wins or loses, just being beaten up?
Well, he's, I don't know, tired, don't talk a lot, just lays on the couch.
You getting a lot of fights in school? Are you going to be a fighter?
No, I don't get in fights.
All right, Larry Jr., good to see you. Good luck to you and your dad. Steve?
All right, Jim, meanwhile, as Larry Holmes ponders the situation, getting ready for a round number seven, the folks in McCall's, oh, big right hand by Holmes. The folks in McCall's corner were saying, don't play to the crowd, stop doing that stuff. Get focused, get serious.
Look how serious Larry Holmes is. And this guy still is coming, pounding away, Larry Holmes in the crowd, loving it.
But I'll tell you what, I have to fight that even because Oliver's not doing the job and Larry is doing the job.
I have him ahead 58 to 56, but some of those rounds could easily go the other way. And since he started play acting, I'm sure a couple have gone the other way.
Great.
McCall has held the title for only about 6 months. Get your hands off the ropes, says Richard Steele to Larry Holmes. He doesn't care how many championships he's won. And now McCall working to the face with the jab.
Punching it out.
See, right there, he's got to get off. Oliver McCall's got to unload there, throw some shots at somebody. He don't have to load up with every one, but he's got to shoot something.
That was the best opportunity to unload right then, and he went into clinch. I mean, you saw it and I saw it. You thought it was going to trigger off.
Watch your hand, okay? Get your hands off
the ropes. Get your hands off the ropes again. The McCall corner wants him to double up on the jab.
That warning from Richard Steele is watch your hands. He pushed him away with an open hand. He might have stuck his thumb in his eye. Obviously, I don't think it was on purpose.
Also, how many times can you warn a guy for holding the ropes? It's illegal, but I never understood why. I mean, it's...
Holmes is looking to fend him off. And he got through with the left hand, McCall. And now the right mission. Now McCall just leaning on the body of Holmes. And Holmes just content to lay against the ropes.
Well, but he took the whole beginning of that round with that fierce fighting ability of his, did Larry Holmes. You know what, he's even on Bobby's card. He's sneaking up on my card. And let me tell you, the sentimental favorite that he is, he could steal this. He could steal this right here in Las Vegas.
Well, McCall's not going to get another invitation to go on David Letterman.
Don't hold him, don't hold
if he continues this.
I'm a bit puzzled by what Oliver McCall's doing. Larry, I knew, would come here to win. I said that to a lot of people who thought he was just doing it for money. I said, that's not why Larry's here. He's here for respect. He's here to win, and he will come and give himself every chance. But I also expected Oliver to prepare himself much better.
Less than 30 seconds in round seven. And in almost magnetic fashion, Holmes right back to the ropes in that corner. Final seconds of the seventh round for the WBC heavyweight title. Let's go over to Jim Gray. Jim?
Thank you, Steve. Luis Santana was taken to Valley Hospital after his fight with Terry Norris. Dr. Flip Pomanski has been in contact with the hospital. Can you tell us and give us an update on Santana's condition?
Luis will be admitted to the hospital for observation. He's had a CAT scan that was normal. He's had an emergency brainwave study, an EEG, that's being read right now. His lab work is normal. It will strictly be for observation. He took a good punch. This is not the same situation that happened in Mexico, but he is alert and talking.
What you're telling us is he's fine, basically.
We hope he's going to be fine. He will be in for observation.
Doctor, we appreciate you taking the time. We are told by Grant Elvis Phillips, who is Luis Santana's manager, that they will no longer fight Terry Norris. They consider him to be a dirty fighter and want nothing else to do with him. Let's go back to Steve.
All right, thank you, Jim. Norris disqualified at the end of round three earlier tonight for hitting after the bell. The bell he says he did not hear, so Santana retains the title on his back.
That's how he won it.
Exactly.
To make a whole career of this.
Unbelievable.
Well, I tell you, all fight long, he's been throwing that right hand. It's getting closer, it's getting closer, and sure, he's got a punch. Larry Holmes has got a punch to knock you out. The further the fight goes, the better Larry Holmes looks, and that's a surprise.
Well,
he should be wearing out, and instead he comes out like gangbusters.
One or two big body shots for Cole Cerrone, a couple to the head, but he's loading up on his shots, and he's making him tired. Takes the same amount of energy to start that punch as it does to stop it if you miss, and that causes fatigue.
McCall looking around over his left shoulder, over his right shoulder. Now he invites Holmes in.
And you know what I don't understand about that is McCall's been winning on the ropes and losing in the center of the ring. So the battle better suited for him right here.
So now in the center of the ring once again, there's the jab by McCall, counter jab by Holmes.
Now McCall is like in slow motion. There's no fury in his fighting. There's no fierceness to it. It's sort of in limbo kind of fighting. I don't know.
He's complaining about a thumb now.
Now he's going to talk about that.
That's it, baby. Use it.
Earlier tonight, we saw another heavyweight championship fight, and that had a lot of action between Seldon and Tucker, and who would have thought that'd be the case?
Well, that was a crisp battle. It was so interesting to see, and such a surprise here. We thought we were going to see fury at the beginning, and these guys have been fighting very slowly at a measured pace. Not interesting.
Well, Larry's doing what he's supposed to do. He's not supposed to try and invoke some wrath of war. You know, he wants to do what he's doing here and not start a barn burn.
I agree with you. For Larry, this is the ideal fight. What I don't understand is McCall. I mean, I understand Larry. I know exactly what he's doing.
McCall with a nice jab, pushing Holmes back. Holmes with his hands way down. Great hand by Holmes that got in. It landed.
Larry's doing what he told me he was going to do, and right now Oliver's not.
Beautiful right hook by Larry Holmes that connected. And McCall peering over the shoulder of Holmes, looking into the ringside seats. Continues to play to the crowd.
Work inside or get out. Come on.
Now he's got Holmes up against the ropes again. Right above us, left hook, crisp left hook by McCall to the head of Holmes. Another left hook by Oliver McCall.
See in here where Oliver's working, Larry, working his body and digging some shots up top. On the ropes is where he's winning the fight, not in the center of the ring, but he walks back out.
Right. This is not to McCall's advantage. Out here in the center of the ring is the bell sound. Back over to Jim Gray. Jim.
Thanks, Steve. I'm with Alethea McCall, Oliver's wife. Oliver was very confident coming into this fight. How do you feel he's doing?
I think he should be a little more aggressive, but other than that, he's doing great. You need to get under Holmes' jab.
You've been sitting here like you want to jump out and get into the ring. You're throwing a few punches. You're hollering and screaming.
Yeah, I should get in there. Whisper something in his ear, let him know he needs to get under Holmes' jab.
You're a little frustrated with what's going on, aren't you?
Not quite frustrated, no.
Are you enjoying this? It took 9 years to get here, and now he's finally here. Are you enjoying this, or would you prefer maybe not to be watching all this?
No, I'm enjoying this a lot.
Thanks for joining us.
Okay.
All right, Steve. Tough time over here.
All right, lovely Alethea McCall with some good instructions.
I think we should ask her to come to our next SCT and add her to our team. She hit exactly what he's supposed to be doing, and she, even a wife, says not energetic enough, not aggressive enough. Maybe they better get her in the corner.
Round number 9, Holmes jab looking sharp in the 8th round. Let's see what happens here. Oliver McCall, the champion, upsetting Lennox Lewis. Larry Holmes, the challenger, 45 years of age. Coming back to the scene of his first heavyweight championship, 1978, when he beat Ken Norton.
Nothing to those punches, Bobby. Nothing.
You know what? I was
punches.
Just 30. I was just going to say it. You took the words out of my mouth. I don't understand what's going on.
He's got a clean shot, and he just powder puffed it. I mean, can't believe this guy. Does he think the championship carries some privilege and just going to give him easy close rounds? I think nostalgia and oh,
big
nice
left
shot.
Hand by McCall. Follows it up to the right, now the left. Combinations by McCall.
I'll tell you what, a couple of those shots got home pretty good.
Cut under the
shook
left.
Shook Larry up a little bit.
Larry Holmes cut under the left eye. Let's see if McCall can continue.
Watch your hand.
McCall. With with a right hand off the top of Holmes's head. But tiring out now. McCall expending a lot of energy.
Watch your head.
So it was a short flurry by Oliver McCall.
It appears to be a cut underneath that Larry's left eye, but and his nose might be bleeding as well.
Here we go, midway through the ninth round. There's a right uppercut by Holmes. Back comes McCall, combination, airing it out.
This is not the fight that Larry needs.
No, Larry, now is a fight that we expected from McCall.
Holmes can't get into a punching contest with McCall. Remember, Richard Steele is the referee. Blood coming from under the left eye of Holmes. Steele watching very closely. Reputation of stopping fights early. 1 minute to go on the night.
You know, I think that reputation for Richard Steele is not quite deserved. He made one questionable call and has never heard the end of it.
Here comes McCall again. Oh, what a left hand by McCall. That snapped Holmes' head back.
And Holmes came back with a combination showing the heart he has, but he's got to step out of that corner.
Maybe he can't, Bobby. Maybe he can't. He's pinned in there by McCall, and he's been hit some real hammering shots. This is the best fighting he's done.
Again, McCall operating to the head of Holmes.
If he can summon up the energy, McCall's got him now. Look at his face.
20 seconds left of the ninth round. What a round for McCall. Combination to the head again by Oliver McCall.
See, Steve, here's where the strength and just not being able to call upon your body at 45 to do what it once could is causing Larry to have some serious problems now.
Very big round for McCall.
And that is it. And what a difference as Alethea McCall approves, the wife of Oliver.
Now, when you go out to this round, that's it, baby. You're all right, baby. Let's get back with that jab.
He's hot, Leroy.
He's hot.
You
got some Vaseline.
I got some Vaseline.
Hold it,
little Vaseline.
Big one, Cliff.
Watch out, John.
That is face of a tired man. 45-year-old man that was beginning to find out that this is a tough game when you're facing a young man. Let's take a look at that left hook. The kind of damage it created the havoc in the corner. But still the heart of Holmes. Still the heart of Holmes as he comes back.
I don't even think that was the first one, too. The first one was even better.
But what a guy. He still came back and forth.
Look how much coagulant substance under the left eye of Larry Holmes. Richard Steele calling time and acknowledging that. Going over to Don Turner. Too much stuff under the left eye. His face all swollen up.
He has a very bad gash there. It's in not a bad place for as far as stopping fights are concerned, but it's a long gash. Looks like maybe even an elbow.
Well, he's puffing up.
The only good news is it's under the eye. Coming off the best round of the fight, Oliver McCall getting the wake-up call. Here we are in round number 10.
Larry came right out, hit him with a good one, too, and then followed it with another one. So Larry's not all that much disturbed by what happened, but he knows he has to adjust.
And he knows he's got to do something to get back in the momentum of this thing because McCall has certainly swung this fight around to him now.
Worker, get out!
Now Holmes brings McCall to his chest.
Don't hold him, Larry. Don't hold him. Come on.
Looking to conserve energy, arguing and complaining to Richard Steele. Been complaining about low blows all night. Steele did warn McCall between rounds a few rounds ago.
Now Holmes always likes to talk and complain. That's nothing new for him.
McCall looking to pick up where he left off in the last round, stopping Holmes.
Punch or get out.
Richard Steele screaming, punch and get out.
Punch or get out of there. Come on, you guys, let's work.
The Holmes corner telling Larry, let's get back to that jab.
He just looked at our camera like he almost got it in his eye. Here comes McCall again.
I'll tell you what, Larry's probably just not able to get out of that corner because that's not where he should be. And McCall doesn't get in any hurry to get back in the corner where he should be.
Incredible.
We'll see if we see more of those potent left hooks by Oliver McCall. Here's the jab by Holmes, having no effect on Oliver McCall.
But your hands are free. Keep working.
It's the 10th round, and he's done way better than I thought he was going to do.
Your hands
I mean,
are
he's
free.
Made
keep
this
working.
An interesting and effective fight. I mean, he's held off the younger man. It's McCall that has
Come
not
on,
covered himself with glory.
Just going to say, what does that say about the champion?
It says he wasn't trying as hard as he knows how.
All right, the jab again by Holmes. It goes back to what got him here. Right hand by Holmes, but a glancing blow. Oh, if that had connected.
And here comes the tape again. They're going to have to call timeout.
Oliver's just waiting too long. He's letting Larry rest where Larry should be pressed. And Larry, to his credit, is stepping to McCall, forcing the fight.
Again, they'll have to do some work on the tape.
I don't know why they don't put electrical tape. That duct tape, you know, no, I'm serious. In some certain countries, they use that duct tape, and it doesn't come off. You got to cut it off. It's really tough. This stuff here is nothing.
30 seconds left in the round with the time called.
Time.
Here we go. A slight blow for both fighters. Round 10 closing down. Holmes loading up with the right, but right off the shoulder of Holmes, able to duck away, McCall able to duck away. And there's the bell to end round 10.
Come in. Put me out now, right?
No.
And he gets a lap?
Mm-hmm. Going to work, baby. Going to work.
Well, I have a call ahead, 96 to 94, but
get the water off and
sure.
Stop there.
Tell you what, Freddie, it is that close. I have it 96 to 94, 96 to 95-ish. It's the kind of fight that so many rounds Oliver just took off, hurt him as far as the scoring is going, and now he started looking for us. He swung the tie, but not by an awful lot.
It's going to come. It's going to come.
Not what we would expect. Let's listen.
Just stay on your step, baby.
It's all right. Just stop, Larry. Don't lose that jab.
Come on, Larry.
Get
cutting up, baby.
Stay on the stick. Stay on the stick. Stay on the stick.
As we head into the championship rounds, round number 11. McCall sending Holmes back with the left jab. Right hand by Holmes, but doing no damage. The jab by Holmes.
Every round seems to start the exact same, Steve, and it just, I don't understand why McCall doesn't press it even harder.
Now he picks it up.
Don't hold him, Larry, don't hold
I think
him.
He waits for Holmes to burn out, and he's got that energy at the very first minute, and then he just burns it out, and then it's nothing for the rest of the round. But he does try. Boy, you got to give it to Larry. He always has had heart. He's always been a champion in his heart.
Combination to the head by Oliver McCall. A right left. Now doubling up on the left hooks is Oliver McCall.
Nice uppercut by Holmes who didn't do anything.
Come on, don't hold him, man.
McCall,
hold him.
You can say what you want, but he looks to be in outstanding physical condition. There were some rumors that he might be out late partying, drinking a little too much beer, but he looks to be in superb condition here late in the fight.
You know, he's strong, and he's now got the mind of a champion, or so he says. And sometimes that makes a fighter rise to the occasion. Maybe he's not fighting the best fight, but he's starting to get the job done. Maybe he relied on his strength in the late round. Who knows?
And maybe he's just too impressed with the fact that Larry has been fighting ever since he was a kid, ever since McCall was a kid. And blood is now beginning to really pour out of his eye, out of Holmes' eye.
It is streaking out from underneath the left eye of Larry Holmes midway through the 11th round. Holmes is hanging on here, holding on
right,
with his glove to the hand of McCall.
McCall's doing some good body work in here, too, that's kind of going unnoticed a little bit. He's digging in there pretty good. It's got to affect Larry at this age, in this stage of the fight.
Well, Holmes in good shape, but you got to remember he's in good shape for a man his age, 45.
And he's getting
work,
beaten, but not taking a shattering beating, not taking that kind of beating where you kind of wince and say, oh, my God, stop the fight.
There's a doubling up of the left.
He's losing. That's all.
Beautiful left jab work there by McCall. Holmes, again, just holding onto the ropes, unloads with the right hand, but back comes McCall.
Punching it out. Punching it out.
Again, that
watch the back end.
Right hand by McCall has a few words for Richard Steele. It says, watch the back end.
Come on,
hands on the rope.
Look at the legs.
If I had to paint a picture of this fight, that was it right there. Him with it eating up and just holding on to that top rope. Oh,
right hand counter by McCall.
Once again, that right hand counter, the same one. He draws a fire with the right hand, leans over and fires his back.
Holmes is opening himself up. 15 seconds left in the 11th round for the WBC heavyweight title.
Well, I for one didn't think we'd go this far. A tribute to Larry Holmes.
Don't hold him.
That's it, baby. Use it.
Well, I'll tell you, Freddie, I actually thought it would probably go the distance because I know Larry, and he's a prideful man and a great fighter.
Sit down, baby. Sit, baby. Sit.
Let's see, drive that. Keep that water off of that as much as possible. All right, let me get in there.
Come on, baby, this is it. Last round, baby.
Give me some water.
Let's work.
Last round, come on.
All you wanted. Let's do it, man. Come on.
A very concerned family. We heard from young Mr. Holmes earlier.
You know, Diane Holmes and my wife are very close.
They got you behind,
Diane took
Larry.
Ball. Kim said, don't let Bobby fight as a heavyweight. And Kim said, Diane, you're married to a heavyweight. Can you tell him what to do?
Yeah.
Let's take a look at that right hand. It didn't land as good as it looked, but it did land. I mean, you know, he's been doing that all night long. This is the last round, and...
And the last time Holmes went 12, June 19th, 92, as they touched gloves. It was a loss to Holyfield for the undisputed heavyweight title. A week later, Oliver McCall lost the 12-round decision to Tony Tucker for the NABF heavyweight title. That was also the last time McCall went 12 rounds, and we thought that was a questionable decision. So here we go, 12th and final round for the WBC heavyweight championship. A battered Larry Holmes at the age of 45, hanging in there.
Battered, but still combative. Still in there with a very good, well-conditioned young man.
The fight might be just a little out of reach for Larry now, but, you know, some of these rounds are very close. Larry, I thought, had a nice little lead early. McCall closed the gap, then he did a little seesawing. I don't even know what
But don't you think, against a champion, even in Nevada, you got to be more convincing than this.
Anything goes in Nevada, Steve.
Yeah, you are right. Chuck Ciampa of Nevada, Barbara Perez of New York, and Tommaso Tomihara of Hawaii. Your judges.
Yeah, but the tide has swung ever since that beating, that battering in the corner there, and it's been all McCall. And here's again a picture of the fight.
That was round nine when Oliver McCall really unleashed that barrage.
Don't hold him, Bright. Step back.
This is the last round. Holmes talking to McCall, saying, come on in. Misses with the right hand. Just flailing away is Holmes.
Punching it out.
Take it, champ. Take it.
Right, come on.
Come on, champ. Well, I hope this discourages him from trying anything else.
It's a nice right hand Larry landed there, but it's a little bit too short on the late side.
And Larry Holmes in desperate need of a knockout here to win this fight, we would think. Coming up to 1 minute remaining in the 12th round.
He's working.
Holmes just loading up with the right hand.
Right, step back. Come on, Larry. Let's go, Larry.
Right hand by McCall that hit air. 50 seconds and counting.
Keep him up. Come on, last round, you got last round.
Richard Steele imploring Larry Holmes. Come on, last round, encouraging him. The crowd now
last round, last
rising.
Round.
You gotta like a referee that coaxes you on.
Less than 30 seconds. McCall bouncing around, looking to finish in strong fashion. Held up on that right hand at the last second of McCall.
Steve, now it's purely a matter of strength and youth, and the 45-year-old body of Larry not being able to deal with what Oliver has left.
Final seconds. McCall finishing with a podium. That is it.
Well, not an auspicious beginning, not a auspicious first fight for the heavyweight champion, McCall, and Larry did did much better than I thought. Kudos to him, but I hope that this points out to him that he should not be in this and get out finally once and for all.
He did say before the fight tonight that if he loses, this will be his last fight. We shall see. Rough night, long night for Larry Holmes, and his face tells the story.
Larry Holmes is a champion person, and he's got a champion heart, was a champion fighter for many years, and I'm also proud to say he's my friend, and I tip my hat to him. No one thought he would do this well. I did. I talked to him. I knew. But again, it's so difficult to call upon a 45-year-old body that's been through so much. It's not just that he was easing along. He fought wars with Tyson, with Weaver, with all of those guys, Ken Norton, and it's just too much, Steve.
He said, if I lose this fight, I'll quit right away. You see the gash under the left eye. He says there's no sense in going on if I lose. Holmes, the WBC and IBF heavyweight champion from 78 to 85, following a stint as Muhammad Ali's sparring partner. And here's Mike Tyson's former sparring partner, Oliver McCall, who's talking it up.
As you can see, he had a good jab, but if you count, I had a better jab. I definitely had a better jab.
You were the man.
Yeah.
I definitely had the better jab. The words of Oliver McCall, who was playing to the crowd for a good portion of this night. Looks like we are ready for the decision, so let's throw it on up to Jimmy Lennon Jr.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 12 rounds of boxing, we have a unanimous decision. Here are the score totals. Judge at ringside, Barbara Pettis scores the bout 114 to 113. Tomotsu Tomihara scores the bout 115 to 114. Judge at ringside, Chuck Giampa scores the bout 115 to 112. All three in favor of the winner. And still champion, the Atomic Bull, Oliver McCall.
You can hear the crowd reacting as those scores are being announced by Jimmy Lennon Jr. Awfully close, Bobby.
I had it just a couple of points myself. Everybody did, and I'm happy to see that the Las Vegas judges are in sync with my way of thinking. It makes me feel good.
Bobby, that could be looked at in two different ways.
Yes, I guess it could.
Oliver McCall, his first title defense, beats Larry Holmes, lifting his record to 26-5, providing himself with an early birthday present. As he turns 30, April the 21st, he wins in very tight fashion, 114, 113, 115, 114, and the judge who had the biggest disparity, Chuck Giampa, 115 to 112, and that was the Nevada judge. The fight doctor standing by with the champion. Right.
Congratulations. You think that old man was going to be that tough a nut?
You know what? I knew he was going to be that tough a nut, the tough a nut. I'm going to tell you, Larry Holmes comes to fight every fucking fight. That's the difference. Excuse the language. Excuse the language, kids. I'm sorry. I have to be a role model, baby. But Larry Holmes comes to fight. As you can see, every time you've seen Larry Holmes come back for that title, he fights his heart out. He fought his heart out against Holyfield, fought his heart out against Tyson, and he fought his heart out against even Ray Mercer when he defeated Ray Mercer. But I showed the people one new thing. Oliver McCall have a devastating jab. As you've seen Larry Holmes work his jab, my jab got to him. It busted him up. And of course, that right hand, which they say is so lucky, split that eye, and I kept the pressure on, but he gave me a hell of a fight.
You won, and there was no question about it, but there was one question remained in all of our heads. What is with all this acting, looking this way and looking that way? You begin to look like Chris Eubank. You're looking over at the corner, you're looking back. What was that?
Well, you know what? That was a little overconfidence that I had on my part, but I had to show the people out there that, hey, Oliver McCall can do little things. I don't have to be a sparring partner, wouldn't dare look over. Only superstars do those things, right? But as you can see, the Atomic Bull can do it. But I guarantee it's my last time doing it because with Tyson, I can't afford to do those things.
You better believe that. You ain't going to be a superstar. You're going to be super sleeping if you do that one.
But I just learned to improve on my thing.
All right, congratulations. Thank back to Jim much. Gray.
Yo.
Thank you, Ferdy. I'm here with Larry Holmes. Larry, how you feeling right now? How's your eye?
Oh, my eye hurts a little bit. My hip hurts more because that's all he was doing, hitting me down a bit on the hip. And I kept telling the ref, but the ref kept letting him do it. So, you know, that's the way it goes sometimes. Sometimes the ref see what he wants, sometimes he don't.
The fight was judged very close. Did you feel you were as close to taking this championship as they scored it?
Oh, yeah, because, you know, when he jabbed, I would jab. We was doing everything together. I was countering inside. And, you know, we was about even all the way because when he throw, I would throw. So it was staying even with him. And, you know, he landed a couple good punches early, and maybe that's what, you know, swayed the judges. So, you know, he fought a good fight. I fought a good fight. He was a little stronger than me tonight, so that's the way it goes.
10 years ago, 8 years ago, would this guy have had any chance against you?
I'll tell you that, man. Everything we say is hype for the fight. But I'm going to tell you, baby, you's a legend to me. I told you that. I still mean that, baby. Congratulations.
Be a good champ.
I'm going to try to. But I just want you to know, all them 7 years you was champ, you was a great champ to me.
Turn it down, you'd be a champion for the people.
Okay, thanks.
That's
John.
All it is. Okay.
But you're still a great champ.
Thanks.
Was this your last fight, Larry?
Yeah. It's no sense for me going on. Give me my rest. There's no sense of me going on anymore. I had my opportunity. Thanks, Don King. Thanks, Showtime. Thanks, WBC, because without those people, I wouldn't be here today. It has been great. And thanks to my wife for giving me the support, you know, to do this.
Larry, thank you very much. Congratulations. You tremendous, courageous effort tonight. Thanks. Let's go back to Steve Albert.
All right, Jim Gray, thank you very much. Some very sound advice from Larry Holmes to Oliver McCall from a true gentleman. And I guess, again, we've seen the end of an era. Your thoughts on this main event?
I think I concur with most boxing experts when I say that Larry Holmes in his heyday, it's a different fight. Larry stays champion. Larry wins the fight. Oliver's still shown that he's got to improve. He's got to do some things better. He can't show off. He can't just think of himself as a superstar. He's got to work like a superstar. And the fight was very close. I only had it a few points, and, you know, that was a close fight.
I know what Purdy thinks. I can probably read the mind of Mrs. Larry Holmes as well, but are you happy to finally see Larry say, I've had it?
My heart goes out to Mr. and Mrs. Holmes. Larry and his wife have been very good friends with me and my wife for a long time, and I know she's wanted them to retire for a while, and they'll get their peace now. I think Larry should eventually get that respect he is so well-deserving of. And I'd like to see him retire, too, because he is a friend, and he's been doing it a long time.
So a very close, unanimous decision for Oliver the Atomic Bull McCall, who retains his WBC Heavyweight Championship in his first defense. Well, on each edition of these broadcasts, we like to present a Fighter of the Night Award, and tonight is no exception. A special panel of judges comprised of members of the boxing media covering tonight's action votes on the Fighter of the Night. Let's take a look at your panel. We've got Tom Archdeacon of the Dayton Daily News, Gerald Eskenazi of the New York Times, and Chris Thorne of the Newark Star-Ledger. And our judges have selected, in unanimous decision fashion, Bruce Seldon, who earlier won the WBA title. So congratulations to WBA heavyweight champ Bruce Seldon for being chosen as the Fighter of the Night. A $5,000 donation will be made in the name of Bruce Seldon to each of these organizations, the United Negro College Fund, the National Hispanic Scholarship Fund, and the University of Nevada at Las Vegas by Showtime Networks and Don King Productions. So here at Caesars Palace in Las Vegas, Nevada, 5 world championship fights on the agenda. It was a long marathon night, and we are standing by to wrap things up. We've got the fight Dr. Ferdy Pacheco somewhere in that big crowd in the center of the ring with Don King. Doctor.
Don, I see those 3 bountiful checks from Don King Productions, from SCT, Showtime. Tell me, what does it mean and what does it signify?
It signifies that we're giving something back to the community. We have an education program, and like many others that we see on television and football games, college games, giving something back to educate our kids. We figured that education may not be a panacea, but it certainly is a wonderful tool in our society today to be utilized to make things a little better for everyone. So Showtime, myself, and I started this. Tony Cox, who was the chairman of the board at the time, agreed that we should give something back to the community. So we have a program now that we are contributing. Every fight in Showtime Championship Boxing and every King Vision SCT fight, we're giving $5,000 to the United Negro Scholarship Fund. We're giving $5,000 to the Hispanic Foundation and the local college of whatever area we're in. So right now we've been in Nevada so much, UNLV has been getting around $30,000, $35,000. We're very happy and delighted that we can make a small token contribution toward something so important.
Well, that's very commendable. And in the area of boxing, one place where you know more than most people, if not all people, what's going to happen to these 2 heavyweight champions? We got a new one in Zeldin, very exciting man. And we have McCall, who is going to be exciting in his day. What do each of them to go now from here?
Well, right now we have Tucker, who is making a protest. He's at the hospital to find out whether he does have bone splinters in his eye, whether he does have a broken nose. If he doesn't have that and the doctor here to stop the fight will have to answer these questions if it's not true. Of course, we can never blame the doctor because safety is first and foremost in all of our hearts. And even if he made an error in the advocacy of safety, we'd have to take it, but it'd have to be a rematch. If Tucker don't have a broken nose, we'd have to give a rematch. Right. However, I commend Bruce Seldon on an exemplary fight. There was a great fight between Tucker and Seldon, and it was really something that people wanted to see. And these guys will continue to go on, and we'll have them fighting either each other if it goes on, or one fight and then unifying the crown, waiting for Mike Tyson.
Oh, how about McCall? You think McCall can, say, go to England and fight? What is happening with him? This summer, what's happening?
McCall wants to go back to England. He wants to fight Bruno, and Bruno is here to make a challenge and drop the gauntlet. And so we make and get McCall and Bruno in the arena over there in London. And I think we could fill it up, you know, and it would, with Nigel Benn fighting someone in a world championship fight, Bruno and McCall in a world championship fight, I think it would be another tremendous show for King Vision SET and Showtime. And we're going to see if we could put that together because Oliver is ready to fight again.
Well, of course, the main news for this whole year has been Tyson. Would you put Tyson, let them unify and fight them, or why would you? Why wouldn't you fight each one separately and let him unify?
Well, that may be the route we go. You know, I'm just waiting on Tyson because Tyson is the boss. And so what we're trying to do is we're going to have a meeting. I think he's going into serious training. He's already been doing some things that is amazing. You would think that his reflexes would be gone, his speed would be gone, but he's astounding everyone that comes in close proximity to him. And he's just a terrific guy, and I just thank God that he blessed us with a wonderful human being like Tyson, and I thank Tyson for selecting me as his promoter. So he's going to get ready, and the fans of the world are waiting for him with a hunger and insatiable appetite. So you'll be seeing him, and we'll be hearing from him. Once he gives us the instructions as to what to do, I will march to his orders.
Well, one last question. All the years that I've been reading newspapers, I don't think I've ever seen such a flurry of misinformation as occurred around this Tyson release. I'm amazed at their lack of honesty and their lack of looking for the truth in journalism. Well, how do you respond to all this misinformation that's been cascading down?
Lies, 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 lies. It was just unbelievable that a journalist would dishonor the journalism. It would dishonor his paper and his editor to just create fiction and print lies after lies after lies because of a zeal of hatred toward an individual. Supersedes his objectivity, his impartiality, his fair play. And so it was a very sad commentary when you see a journalist do this and use the power of his journalistic pen and the prestige of the paper which he works for to create a rumor that was propagandized and a big lie that went around the world. So it's a sad day for this here. I hope that it doesn't happen again. Most certainly everyone is looking at it now to see what it really is. And it was very humiliating, embarrassing, and just outrageous, but it was certainly nothing but lies from the beginning to the end.
And the sad part is we live in such a sensational society that snowballed all over the country, and that went out as a true story instead of a misinformation. But we've got to get back to Steve Albert at ringside and my friend Bobby Chess.
All right. Thank you very much. Fight doctor Ferdy Pacheco, as this big crowd of about 15,000 files out. That wraps it up from ringside. As a marathon night of boxing comes to a close, as we head for the bell, let's send it back up to Jim Hill one last time with Marvelous Marvin Hagler. Jim?
All right, Steve, thank you very much. Well, Marvelous, what a night we've had. And even though Oliver McCall won, you're really disappointed in his performance.
Yeah, I really was a little bit, but I believe he's got over his first test as being a champion, and he may improve a lot better the next time out.
What do you think he will learn, or he did learn from this fight, that will help him in the future?
Well, Larry gave a good account of himself and showed courage and everything. I'm quite sure that he will endure the same thing from Larry's performance.
And I know that you really appreciate it because you hunched me when Larry gave him a couple of bits of advice in the ring about being a good champion.
I thought that was a very good advice, and I would have did the same myself.
Because Oliver likes to talk. Likes to talk too much, in your opinion?
Well, you know, I guess that that's his thing right now until he learns. He has to learn.
Well, Marvin, it has been great having you here, and we hope to have you back again sometime. Let's do it all over again, huh?
That sounds great to me.
I'm all for that. Showtime Championship Boxing returns April the 29th when IBF Junior Middleweight Champion Vincent Petway makes his first title defense against former WBC champion Simon Brown. These boxers both live near and will be fighting at the U.S. Air Arena in Landover, Maryland. See these two D.C. area rivals battle on Showtime, 9:35 p.m. Eastern and Pacific Time. Tonight, Caesar's Palace was indeed the home of champions. So before we go, let's review the results from the evening's five world title fights from here in Las Vegas, Nevada.